Students, whatever homework is given to you, you have to submit it on the very next day between 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. to the given WhatsApp number, and it is compulsory to submit your homework as your attendance will be marked on the basis of your submission.
Hello students, good morning. Welcome back again. Today we are going to start in chapter number 3, Measures of Central Tendency, Mode, in exercise 3.5. Mode formula. If raw observation or raw data are there, then if we have to find out mode in that, so in that we will find out most repeated observation, that would be our mode. In discrete frequency distribution, observation of highest frequency, we have to find out highest frequency. In front of that, which observation is there, that would be our mode. If continuous frequency distribution is there, then we have to go for this formula, mode equal to L plus FM minus F1 divided by 2FM minus F1 minus F2 into C. If highest frequency is repeated or class lengths are not equal, if one highest frequency is not there, it is repeated more than one, or class length, first we have to see that class length is equal or not. Here if class length is, lengths are not equal, then we go for empirical formula, in that mode equal to 3m minus 2 mean. Here you have to find out mean, then median, then you can use this formula. Now sum number 1 in exercise 3.5. The IQ levels of students in a class are given below. Find the modal value. Find the modal value, means mode. Value of IQ level of students. Here, you have given us observation, raw observation, 146, 134, 143. Here, in this, you have to see which observations have repeated more than one. Here, 146 is repeated two times. 146 is repeated two times. Or 138 is repeated three times. We can see that value of 138 is repeated three times, which is more than the number of repetition of any other value of the observation. So here, mode value of IQ level is M equal to 138. This would be our answer. Now, second number sum. The following table gives the number of cakes sold each day at a bakery. Find the mode for sale of cakes. Here, in this sum, discrete frequency has given, number of cakes, 10 cakes, number of days, 5, 12 cakes, 9 days. Here they have given observation. What we have to do here? Here, we have to find out maximum frequency. Maximum frequency means this is our maximum frequency, but this is not our mode. We have to find out mode into the column of observation variable. So in front of frequency in x column, in x variable observation, that would be our mode. So here mode equal to 13. What we have done? We see highest frequency is there, 25, in front of that class, in front of that highest frequency, our discrete frequency observation is 30. So mode for sale of cake is 30. 13. Now sum number 33. The distribution of ages of 48% in an old age home is given below. Which formula will be appropriate to find the mode? Which formula is appropriate to find the mode? Here we have to decide by which formula we have to find mode. So here you have given two formulas. One formula for general sum and second is for empirical formula. We go for that method. Now why find the modal class, mode find out age of the person in the old age home using the formula you have chosen. Now see here, first two things you have to see here. One is you have to find out highest frequency, or frequency is repeating more than one time or not. So here highest frequency is 19. Second, you have to see class length is equal or not. So here 50 to 60, 10 class length is there. 60 to 65, 5 class length. 65 to 75, 70 to 85, 15 class length. 85 to 100, 15 class length. So here class length is not equal. Here class length of all classes are not equal. So we can find the mode by empirical formula. For that formula is mode equal to 3m minus 2 mean. Now the following calculations are carried out to find mean and median. Because for empirical formula we have to find out median or mean both. So class here given us, frequency already given us. Now for finding mean we have to go for formula sigma fx upon n. So for finding sigma fx, first we have to find out fx. For finding fx we have to find out f or x. So x means mid value, because here they have given us continuous class. So for finding mid value, 50 plus 60 divided by 2, we will get 55. Then we will multiply 6 into 55, we will get 330. According to this method, we will find out mid value, then fx, then find out sigma fx. Now for finding median we need cumulative frequency cf. Here in this column we can also make one more column of cf, find out cf. F in f column 6, we will write down here 6 plus 10 16, 16 plus 19 35, 35 plus 9 44, 44 plus 4 48. Now for finding mean formula, mean equal to sigma fx upon n. Sigma fx equal to 3305 divided by n. Means n means frequency column total is our n. So sigma fx divided by n, 3305 divided by 48, we will get 68.85. Now we have mean 68.85. now for finding mean, this is continuous frequency distribution, so we have to find out mean by this method. First we will find out n upon 2th observation. N means 48, total 48. 48 upon 2, 24th observation. According to CF table, class would be 65 to 70. You already know 65 to 70 means this is our L. Class length is 5. Then frequency class 19. Previous class of frequency 16. Now we will put this all value into the formula. M equal to L plus N upon 2 minus CF upon F into C. Put all values into the formula. 65, 48 upon 2 minus 16 upon 19 into 5. Then as it is 65, 48 divided by 2, 24 minus 16 divided by 19 into 5. As it is 65, 24 minus 16, 8 divided by 19 into 5. 65 by, after solving this, we will get 2.11. 65 plus 2.11, not 11. Don't say anytime 11, 2.11. Now, 65 plus 2.11 mod equal to 67.11. Now, we are going to put all values into the empirical formula. Mod equal to 3m minus 2 mean. Mod equal to 3, our median is 67.1, write down here, minus 2, mean is 68.85. Mod equal to 3 in brackets 67.11 minus 2 mean is 68.85. Now solve this. 3 into 67.11 we will get 201.33 minus 2 multiplied by 68.85 we will get 137.7. After deducting, we will get mod equal to 63.63. So, the modal age of the person in the old age home is 63.63 years. Sum number 4. Comment on the mode for the following data showing the time taken in seconds for 8 competitors in a running race. Here they have given us observation, and in sum you have to comment. Okay, see here 25.2, 26.2, 28.2, 32.1, 29.0, 29.3, 31.3, 27.8. Here no observation is repeating. So, we cannot find out mode by using its general formula. If you have to find out mode, you have to go for empirical formula. You have to find out mean, you have to find out median, then you can find out mode. But here, this is theory question, only you have to comment. You are not going to find out mode, only you have to comment. So, write down answer. Here no observation is repeated. Mode cannot be found using its general formula. Now, sum number 5. The table below shows the data about weights of 86 apples from a garden. Find the mode for the weight of apples. Weight of apple in gram given 120 to 130. 8 apples are there. 130 to 140 grams. 13 apples are there. And so on. Now, find the mode for the. Here we have to find out mode. Okay. So if you are solving sum, then first you have to see any frequency is repeating or not. So see here frequency 8, 13, 19, 23, 10, 8, 5. No frequency is repeating more than once. Highest frequency is 23. Now, here in C, Second thing, in continuous frequency column, 120 to 30, 10 class length is there. 130 to 140, 10 class length is there. 140 to 150, 10 class length is there. 150 to 160, 10 class length is there. 160 to 170, 10 class length is there. 170 to 180, 10th class is there. 180 to 190, 10 class is there. So, here, highest frequency is 23, so our class is 150 to 160. Here, no mode is repeating, highest frequency is not repeating, class length is equal, so we can find out mode by using general formula. Okay, here this is our highest frequency. According to mode formula, L plus FM minus F1 divided by 2FM minus F1 minus F2 into C. Now, according to formula, L equal to, this is our maximum frequency 23, 150 to 160, L is our 150, FM mode, FM, previous class, F1, succeeding class, F2, C equal to class length, 150 to 160, so C equal to 10. Now, all these value we will put into the formula. L equal to 150, FM equal to 23, F1 19, F2 10, C equal to 10. Now, mode equal to, write down formula first, L plus FM minus F1 divided by 2FM minus F1 minus F2 into C. Put all values, L equal to 150, FM equal to 23, F1 equal to 19, FM equal to 23 into 2, F1 equal to 19 minus F2 equal to 10 into 10. Write down 150 as it is plus 23 minus 19 equal to 4. 23 into 2, 46, minus 19 and minus 10 equal to minus 29 into 10 as it is. 150 right as it is plus 4 right as it is. 46 minus 29, 17 into 10 as it is. Write down 150 as it is. Solve all these. 4 divided by 17 into 10, we will get 2.35. By adding this, we will get 152.35. Now, modal weight for apple is 152.35 grams. So, students, here we are completing chapter number 3, Measures of Central Tendency. In next lecture, we will start measures of dispersion. Till then, keep studying. Thank you.